In real estate, you make money when you buy, not when you sell. That being said, you need to buy at a good price, below market value. And foreclosures are a good way to find great deals. If you're looking to buy a foreclosed property, then check this video out. And please click on that like button while you're at it. What is a foreclosed property? A foreclosed property is a property owned by a loan institution such as a bank or pag-ibig that eventually goes to auction, where the loan institution tries to recoup the money for the property. Since this is considered a non-performing asset, an asset that is not income generating, banks actively market them so they can be disposed of as fast as possible. A foreclosure is the process in which the bank seizes a property in the event that the buyer fails to make mortgage payments. Buying a foreclosed property can be a good investment, but you need to check the actual status of the property to make sure that there are no problems that go with the sale. When a property goes into foreclosure, there are owners that refuse to give up ownership of the foreclosed property. They try to hold on to it by either not moving out or by filing a court case that can go on and on for years just to delay the bank's possession of the property. And so as the buyer, this is what you need to look out for, because you don't want to buy a property that may take you years to use because of a stubborn owner. So be sure to check the property status, check if the title has already been transferred under the bank's name, and thus it's already fully owned by the bank. This would be safest to buy because this means the title is already clean. Buying foreclosed properties can be good investments because foreclosed properties are usually sold below market value. For instance, a client of mine bought a foreclosed property in Montaña Vista. It's a 3-bedroom house at 120 square meters. It's a house and lot with a current value of between 2.5 to 3 million. Now it's at 3 million, but it was just selling at 1.5 million, a very good deal. So today, I will be sharing with you the first foreclosed property that we bought, how we did it, and the requirements that we submitted. Where did we find the property? Foreclosures can be found through lending institutions such as HDMF or Pag-ibig, banks, City Hall, SSS, or NHA, National Housing Authority. So for this particular property that we bought, we found it through a bank. And there are 5 steps that we took to acquire this property. First is we checked the property. There are seasoned investors who sometimes don't check the property anymore if it's way below market value and they know the area well, but especially if it's a lot only. But since this was our first investment, we wanted to be on the safe side, and I really do advise for you to check the property first, especially if it's a house and lot, to see the condition of the property and how much you might need to spend to renovate it. The property was located in Santa Barbara, so we drove to the area and checked it out immediately. So when we got there, we saw that the house needed repair, all the tiles needed to be replaced. The second floor bedrooms didn't even have tiles, and the interior of the property was a little dark because there weren't enough windows to let the light in. There were 2 kitchens as well, which was redundant, and there was a very small living area, so it didn't make sense because there was a small living area but 2 kitchens, which that house didn't really need 2 kitchens. But overall, the house was still in a very good condition. It had strong foundation, no leaks, no plumbing problems, no leaking problems. So we decided to put in a bid on the property. Now this brings us to step number 2. So the second step that we took was we made an offer on the property. We submitted a bid. When it comes to foreclosed property, the bank will put it up for auction first, and of course it will go to the highest bidder. Now if no one bids during the auction period, then the property will be up for a negotiated sale at a specific price point set by the bank. So since this particular house was up for auction, we submitted our bid. We filled up the bank bid form, submitted it along with 2 valid IDs, and emailed everything to the bank. So in the bid form, we indicated our personal information and the bid price. If you have never bid in a foreclosed property, here's a tip for you. To increase your chances of winning, you will need to bid above the bid price. Also, you cannot bid below the bid price, as this will disqualify you from the auction. So the more attractive a property is, the more bidders it will have. And also another tip is don't bid a whole number. For example, if the property is priced at 5 million and you want to bid at 5.3, for example, you can bid at 5,323,121 pesos instead of 5.3, because it is a bidding war and those couple thousand pesos might make the difference between losing or winning the auction. As to how much you need to bid will depend on you. But if you want to be guided on your bid price, then contact me so that we can schedule a consultation. Foreclosed properties, as I mentioned, have a minimum bid price which you cannot bid below that amount. So again, if let's say the bid price is at 1.5 million, then you will need to start the bid at 1.5 or higher. If you want to win, you need to bid higher. I had a client who I helped in acquiring a foreclosed property. It was, as I mentioned, a bungalow in Gran Europa. So the market value was at 3 million, as I mentioned, and it was only selling at 1.5. So it, since it was such a good deal, it was highly likely that there would be other bidders as well. So I recommended an amount that she had to put down as her bid. And needless to say, she won the auction and got the property. I had another client who bid on a foreclosed Ridge lot in Fresno. So ridge lots there are already at 15,000 to 16,000 per square. And he was able to get that property at only around 10,000 per square meter. So it was way, way below market value. Now, if the foreclosed property is already on negotiated sale, the first step is to make an offer. You can either offer directly to the bank or course it through a real estate broker. I would recommend coursing it through a broker so you will have someone to help you out with the entire process, as each bank has a different process when it comes to acquiring foreclosed assets. There is no additional cost to you since it is the bank who will be paying the broker's fee. And even if you didn't have a broker, the selling price would still stay the same. So why not get that extra help? By the way, if at any point during this video you've decided you're interested in investing in a foreclosed property and want to schedule a Zoom consultation with me, send me a message in Viber or WhatsApp. My contact info is in the description box. Now, the third step that we took was to wait for the auction result. Upon receipt of our bid, we waited for 3 days for the results to be out. After 3 days, the bank then contacted us to inform us that we had won the auction. We had actually bid on multiple properties prior to the Santa Barbara house, but our offers would either get rejected or we would lose the auction to another buyer. Since we are investors, we didn't have emotional attachment to any of these properties. So if we'd lose, then no hard feelings, it's not for us. We didn't want to force anything. So since we won this particular property, we felt that this was a house that the Lord had really set apart for us. So we completely renovated the entire house. And if you want to check out how it turned out, watch till the end of this video. And then the fourth step is to comply with the necessary requirements. Now, since we had won the bid, the next step was for us to comply with the needed requirements because the bank will ask you for requirements even if you are paying in cash. So the requirements you need to submit are similar to what you would need to give for when applying for a home loan, such as valid IDs, income documents, marriage contract. Even if you offer again to pay in cash, some banks will still need to ask for these documents to screen you. So just like my client who bought the foreclosed property in Gran Europa, although she was a cash buyer, the bank still asked her for all the needed requirements. So in our case naman, for the Santa Barbara property, we wanted to buy it through a home loan. We put in a 20% down payment on the property and the rest would be paid through financing. So we applied at the same bank for financing and then we got approved in about 2 weeks. And then the fifth step, the last step, is to sign the deed of sale and a turnover of the property. So around week number 3, we had the water and electricity reconnected. We also signed the loan documents and the deed of sale. After this, the property got turned over to us. So the whole process took us about 1 month to complete. And that's how we bought our first foreclosed property in 5 steps. So again, the first step was we checked the property. Second step, submit a bid. Third, wait for a bid result. Fourth, comply with the needed requirements. And fifth, sign the deed of sale and turnover of the property. Now, as I mentioned in my video, we completely renovated the house. So check this out so you will see how it turned out. And that's it for today's vlog. If you want to schedule a consultation with me on how to buy a foreclosed property, send me an email or contact me on WhatsApp or Viber. My contact info is in the description box. If you want my free ebook on my buyer's guide for buying property in the Philippines, then send me an email so I can email you a copy.